Good evening, I'm Mahamtawa with the news making headlines around the world. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah arrives in the Moroccan city of Rabat on a private visit. His Highness the Emir continues to receive cables of congratulations on honoring His Highness as a humanitarian leader. U.S. President Barack Obama lays out his strategy for confronting the Islamic State group in Iraq and Syria. And U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry attends a regional meeting on terrorism across the Middle East in Jeddah. In our first item, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah and the official accompanying delegation return home tomorrow evening, Friday, the 12th of September 2014, coming from the Kingdom of Morocco after a private visit. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah, accompanied by His Excellency Deputy Chief of the National Guard, Sheikh Mishal Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah, and the accompanying delegation, arrived at Rabat International Airport this morning on a private visit. His Highness was received at the airport by the Governor of Rabat City, Abdel Wafi Al-Fatit, and Kuwait Ambassador to the Kingdom of Morocco, Shamlan Abdelaziz Al-Rumi. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah, accompanied by His Excellency Deputy Chief of the National Guard Sheikh Mishal Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah and the accompanying delegation, left John F. Kennedy Airport in New York yesterday evening after a private visit to the United States of America. His Highness was seen off at the airport by the advisor at the Emiri Diwan Muhammad Abdullah Abul Hassan, Kuwait's ambassador to the USA Sheikh Salim Abdullah Al-Jaber Al-Sabah, Kuwait permanent representative at the United Nations Mansour Ayad Al-Atebi, and Kuwait Consul General in the city of Los Angeles, Abdel Latif Lehaya, and members of Kuwait Permanent Mission at the UN. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah visited His Excellency Sheikh Mbarak Al-Abdallah Al-Ahmed Al-Sabah at his residence in the Moroccan capital, Rabat. His Highness was accompanied by His Excellency Deputy Chief of the National Guard, Sheikh Mishal Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Excellency President Dr. Mohamed Al-Munsif Al-Marzouqi of the Republic of Tunisia on the occasion of naming His Highness the Emir as the humanitarian leader of the world and awarding Kuwait the title of International Humanitarian Center by the United Nations. The Tunisian President praised His Highness the Emir's support to humanitarian work, which boosted Kuwait's position worldwide, adding that this initiative by the United Nations came in recognition of the outstanding role being played by the state of Kuwait to help victims of natural disasters, war, and armed struggle. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable thanking His Excellency the Tunisian President for his kind feelings and good wishes on the occasion of being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as International Humanitarian Center. His Highness highly appreciated the Tunisian President's praise to the great contributions and support being given by the State of Kuwait to humanitarian work across the world, adding that this kind feeling reflected the strength of brotherly relations between Kuwait and Tunisia and their people. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Zayed Al-Nahyan, representative of the President of the United Arab Emirates. He congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as International Humanitarian Center. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness representative of the United Arab Emirates President has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Mohammed bin Sultan Al Qasimi, Crown Prince of Sharjah. He congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Ammar bin Hamid Al Naimi, Crown Prince of Ajman, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. He also wished His Highness all the best of health. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness the Crown Prince of Ajman has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received the cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Saud Saqr Al Qasimi, Crown Prince of Ras Al Khaimah, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Rashid bin Saud bin Rashid Al Mualla, Crown Prince of Umm Al Qiwan, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. He also wished His Highness the Emir all the best of health. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received the cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Sharqi, Crown Prince of Al Fujairah, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. He also wished His Highness the Emir all the best of health. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Salim Al Qasimi, Deputy Ruler of Sharjah, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. He also wished His Highness the Emir all the best of health. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated this fraternal gesture on his part. His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah received a cable of congratulations from His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, Deputy Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Bahrain, in which he congratulated His Highness the Emir on being named by the United Nations as humanitarian leader and Kuwait as international humanitarian center. He praised this honoring by the United Nations, which came in recognition and appreciation of the effective part and noble initiatives being undertaken by His Highness the Emir and the State of Kuwait to extend its assistance and relief materials to the victims of wars, armed conflicts, and natural disasters in different parts of the world. His Highness the Deputy Premier of the Kingdom of Bahrain said, "Those contributions boosted Kuwait's prestige and role at international levels." He also wished His Highness the Emir all the best of health and for Kuwait everlasting prosperity and progress under His Highness' prudent leadership. His Highness the Emir sent a reply cable expressing his thanks and appreciation for the kind feelings which His Highness the Deputy Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Bahrain has expressed in his cable. His Highness the Emir also highly evaluated the humanitarian role being played by the State of Kuwait to relieve people in need of urgent help in different parts of the world. His Highness the Emir said those kind of feelings reflect the strong existing relations between the two countries and their people, and wish the Kingdom of Bahrain and its honorable people continuous progress and prosperity under the wise leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Highness Sheikh Jabir bin Mubarak Al Hamad Al Subah, the Prime Minister, welcomed the formation of the new Iraqi government headed by Haider Al Abadi, which has gained the confidence of the Iraqi Parliament. In a statement to Kuwait news agency Kuna, His Highness the Prime Minister expressed this move to enhance national unity of Iraq and retain its sovereignty and security in order to overcome the current adversities and return to its role on the regional and international levels. His Highness expressed hope in working with the new Iraqi government to further improve bilateral relations for the mutual interest of both countries. The first Deputy Premier and Foreign Minister, Sheikh Subah Al Khalid Al Hamad Al Subah, arrived in Jeddah today to take part in the ministerial meeting on the situation in the Middle East. The minister was received upon arrival in King Abdulaziz International Airport by the Saudi Deputy Foreign Minister, Prince Abdulaziz bin Abdullah, General Consul of the State of Kuwait in Jeddah and Permanent Representative of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, Saleh Ali Suqabi, Charge d'Affaires at the State of Kuwait's Embassy in Riyadh, Wael Lanizi, and members of the State of Kuwait's General Consulate in Jeddah. The Deputy Premier, Minister of Interior and Acting Minister of Awqaf and Islamic Affairs, Sheikh Mohammed Al Khalid Al Hamad Al Subah, today met with the Governor of Mubarak Al Kabir, retired General Ahmed Abdel Latif Lirshaib. The Deputy Premier, Minister of Interior and Acting Minister of Awqaf and Islamic Affairs also met with the columnist Saad Lamatish. The Minister of Information and Minister of Youth Affairs, Sheikh Salman Subah Al-Salem Mahmoud Al-Subah, visited the United Nations House in Mishraf this week in honor of His Highness the Emir, Sheikh Subah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Subah, being awarded as a humanitarian leader by the United Nations. His Highness the Emir's award comes in appreciation of his and Kuwait's role in supporting charities and humanitarian causes worldwide. Our reporter Badriya Saleh was at the UN House to bring us this story.
Minister of Information and Minister of State for Youth Affairs, His Excellency Sheikh Salman Sabah Al-Salem Mahmoud Al-Sabah, attended a tour of the United Nations House in Mishrif, organized in honor and anticipation of His Highness the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah, being awarded as a humanitarian leader by the United Nations. It was a gathering to support and celebrate the Emir's accomplishment, as well as to reflect on the long and strong ties between Kuwait and the UN.
The purpose of my visit to the UN offices here in Kuwait in this historic day to express our deep appreciation and thanks to the United Nations for their distinction to His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah as humanitarian leader, a great humanitarian leader, and also to Kuwait as a center for the humanitarian works. We hope that such distinction will give us more effort and desire to work together with the United Nations. Also, I'd express my appreciations for their presence, support to the development of Kuwait and its prosperity in the short, medium, and long term.
Today, we were honored to receive His Excellency Sheikh Salman to the UN House, the Kuwaiti House. We are extremely happy and honored with this visit to celebrate together this very, very important event of honoring His Highness the Emir as the humanitarian leader, and also for honoring Kuwait as a humanitarian international humanitarian city. It is an acknowledgement of the key role that Kuwait is playing in supporting the international humanitarian work, and the donations that have been given by Kuwait, especially in the last two donor conferences. conferences for Syria, pledging conferences for Syria, have helped millions of people and continue to help in the survival of millions of people who are in utmost need of help. Kuwait is playing a key role, and the UN is very ready to stand by and support all the Kuwaiti demarches, and to thank Kuwait also for mobilizing this international support for the humanitarian work.
His Highness the Emir's award and the state of Kuwait being recognized as a global humanitarian center comes in appreciation of the role of the country in supporting charities and humanitarian causes worldwide. A member state for 50 years, Kuwait shares a tight bond with the UN and extends an eager hand to help whenever possible. This past year alone, Kuwait hosted two UN Syria Donors Conferences, raising a total of more than $2.4 billion in 2014 alone. Around the state of Kuwait on this night of September 9th, many people are gathered to show their support and great pride in His Highness the Emir, as well as to be a part of this significant achievement. At the UN House in Mishrif, this is Badriya Saleh, reporting for The English News.
The Governorate of Mubarak al-Kabir held a ceremony at Jumeirah Hotel to celebrate the honoring of His Highness the Emir Sheikh Subah al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Subah by the United Nations as a pioneer in humanitarian initiatives. The ceremony was attended by officials, diplomats and NGOs. Our reporter Renwa Jabouri was there and has the following report.
His Highness the Emir Sheikh Subah al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Subah has been honored by the United Nations as a pioneer in the field of goodness and humanity. His Highness attended a ceremony at the UN's headquarters in New York, where UN Secretary Ban Ki-moon presented His Highness the Emir with a Humanitarian Leader Award.
I would like to communicate the congratulations for this occasion, and Argentina, it's very happy to be in this celebration in honor for the Emir.
I'm very glad and I congratulate His Highness the Emir for being named the International Humanitarian Leader, and the State of Kuwait for being named as International Humanitarian Center. It's a very fitting recognition of the humanitarian things that the State of Kuwait is doing and His Highness is doing too. I recall that during the typhoon in the Philippines last November 2013, Kuwait was one of the first countries to come to the aid of the Philippines by His Emir offering $10 million in assistance, which helped very much in the ameliorating the living conditions of the victims of the typhoon.
World Humanitarian Day was only recently commemorated around the globe under the slogan "The world needs more humanitarian heroes," and His Highness the Emir's humanitarian initiatives are without a doubt synonymous with the slogan, in which the Emir has indeed been a humanitarian hero, helping millions of people around the globe in suffering find a kind helping hand, alleviate their pain.
I think today is a very auspicious and historic day for Kuwait. It's another milestone of what Kuwait has done. So I've been here for the last 3 years, and I've been attending a few conferences, especially the two international humanitarian conference on Syria, where the Emir on behalf of Kuwait has made generous contribution towards a good cause. So I think the honor conferred upon the Emir, His Highness the Emir, and also upon Kuwait is timely, and I think it fits the whole purpose of what His Highness the Emir and also what Kuwait is doing.
We're very happy to be here as representative of the International Committee of the Red Cross at the invitation of His Excellency the Governor of Mubarak El Kebir. And I would like to join my voice to all those who have already spoken before me in order to really praise His Highness the Emir of Kuwait and the people of Kuwait and the state of Kuwait for this fantastic humanitarian effort they've been doing for so many years, not only in the neighboring countries but all over the world, trying to bring relief to those in need of help, be it from the consequences of armed conflict or natural disaster, without any political interest and in a totally without any type of discrimination. And the Red Cross and Red Crescent movement also has largely benefited from the generosity of Kuwait. So the only thing we can say is Alfi Mabruk and Alfi Shukran.
His Highness the Emir has extended his kind, generous hand to countless countries in disaster, including Gaza, Sudan, Iraq, Lebanon, Yemen, and other countries of the African and European fingerprints, find comfort and hope during difficult and challenging times.
His Highness the Emir Sheikh Subah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Subah's humanitarian initiatives have been phenomenal, to say the least. Tonight's ceremony was about honoring such initiatives. From the Jumeirah Hotel, I'm Geno Jabiri reporting to you for the English News.
Opening a new military front in the Middle East, President Barack Obama authorized U.S. airstrikes inside Syria for the first time, along with expanding strikes in Iraq as part of an effort to root out the Islamic State or the IS militants. Obama announced that he was dispatching nearly 500 more U.S. troops to advise and assist Iraqi security forces, as well as conduct intelligence and inspection flights, bringing the total number of American forces sent there this summer to more than 1,500. He also urged the U.S. Congress to authorize a program to train and arm Syrian rebels who are fighting both IS militants and the Syrian regime of President Bashar al-Assad. The president insisted that his plan to degrade and ultimately destroy the IS militants would not involve returning U.S. combat troops to the Middle East.
We will conduct a systematic campaign of airstrikes against these terrorists. Working with the Iraqi government, we will expand our efforts beyond protecting our own people and humanitarian missions so that we're hitting ISIL targets as Iraqi forces go on offense. Moreover, I've made it clear that we will hunt down terrorists who threaten our country wherever they are. That means I will not hesitate to take action against ISIL in Syria as well as Iraq.
A regional meeting on the subject of terrorism across the Middle East kicked off today in the Saudi Arabian city of Jeddah. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry today started an intensive series of meetings with Arab officials to coordinate strategy against the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. The meetings are being hosted by Saudi Arabia, which has agreed to provide bases for the training of Syrian rebels who are battling IS militants and the Assad regime in Damascus. The talks will include GCC member states, Egypt, Jordan, Turkey, Lebanon, and Iraq. Kerry began his discussions with Saudi Foreign Minister Prince Saud Al Faisal and is scheduled to be in more bilateral meetings during the gathering. Kerry called for supporting President Barack Obama's plans for a new military campaign against the IS militants, including help with greater overflight rights for U.S. warplanes. And in our final item tonight, Palestinians said that they are returning to the indirect negotiations brokered by Egypt in Cairo to set a final agreement for the ceasefire between Palestinian resistance factions and the Israeli government. The talks are expected to pick up in 2 weeks. From the West Bank, Fatma Abdelkarim has the details.
Members of the Palestinian delegation for the indirect Cairo talks with Israel said they are returning to the Egyptian capital within the coming 2 weeks for the final ceasefire agreement between Palestinian resistance factions and the Israeli army.
We were informed by the Egyptian side that both the Israeli and Palestinian sides have agreed to come to negotiations. And this is contrary to what Netanyahu declared before, and that they are going to issue an invitation very soon, and negotiations will resume probably within 10 days. These negotiations are very important because they relate to the real issues of lifting the siege on Gaza.
Palestinians believe this is the toughest round of talks so far, due to the nature of the issues on the table, such as lifting the siege on the Gaza Strip. But moreover, the talks are considered to be even tougher as the Israeli army unravels the other face of the Israeli policy by continued settlement activity announcements and killing of Palestinian youth, as well as shooting on Gaza's fishermen in the sea.
It is a battle to stop and open the gates, stop the siege on Gaza Strip. Gaza is the biggest jail in all over the world. The people are suffering from all the Israeli forms of escalation against our people. I think the people needs a real position from the international community.
The dates set for the talks are not yet final, but are expected right before the interim ceasefire ends between the 20th and the 25th of September. Besides lifting the siege, the talks could also include the fourth batch of veteran Palestinian prisoners to be released and both the sea and airports. Israel intensifies the negativity around the time of the end of the interim ceasefire agreement and opens new paths for violence and tension in the West Bank and Gaza. In the face of the Palestinian Unified Delegation for the talks, which obviously knows its mission is a tough one. Fatma Abdelkarim, Kuwait TV, Ramallah, Palestine.
For a chance to see our reports again, please visit our YouTube channel at MOI Kuwait News. Well, with that, we conclude our news bulletin. Thank you for joining us. Have a pleasant time. I'm Maham Tawa. Before we go, we remind you once again of our main top stories. Have a pleasant time and good night. His Highness the Emir, Sheikh Subah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Subah, arrives in the Moroccan city of Rabat on a private visit. His Highness the Emir continues to receive congratulatory cables on honoring His Highness as a humanitarian leader. U.S. President Barack Obama lays out his strategy for confronting the Islamic State group in Iraq and Syria. And U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry attends a regional meeting on terrorism across the Middle East in Jeddah.